Hold on, before we get into the video, if you guys are tired of playing Minecraft, you want your badges fast so you can hit the park ASAP, make sure y'all go hit up my boy Star Grinders on Twitter and IG to get your badges grinded fast, easy, and legit. The number one trusted badge grinding service in the 2K community. Make sure you tell him that Dunga sent you. Link to his Twitter and IG will be in the description below. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Hey, look, man. Finally done grinding my player. His badge, by the way, you know. Just got to get that 95 overall. But look, finally got the last defensive badge. The last defensive badge, and we unlocked the Mamba Mentality badge. So now we could change the takeover. And now it's working. Look, we unlocked every single takeover now, so now we can change the takeover wherever we want. We don't have to choose one. We could, you know, we could do whatever we want, but you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna tell y'all the easiest way to get it, man. So, you know, I went and changed my takeover, you know. I changed the spot of precision, you know, because I played the park, you know, I played my fair share of park in the game, just in general itself, you know. I decided to change up a few things about my player, man. And the first thing I changed was, you know, I needed that limitless range takeover, bro. Cause I go against people who have that badge, and not only is it overpowered, but it looks fun as heck. Because when you have Hall of Fame deep threes and that badge, you're different. You're really different, bro. You're pulling up from the logo. It's tough. It's really tough, and it looks super fun to do. So, just to get those type of clips to put in my video, yes, I'm using the limitless range. Definitely, I need those clips. And the secondary one, you know, instead of extreme cleanse, which is a really good takeover, I just decided to try the enhanced jump shot contest just to see how it's rocking with. Cause we use the extreme cleanse. We see what's it about, you know. I just want to venture off and get the best of the best, see what's the best, you know what I'm saying? So we picked that as our secondary. But I'm gonna tell you how to get it now, the easiest way. So we basically know that you need to get all your finishing badges, shooting, playmaking, and defense. So the easiest way to get all of those is pretty simple. You can get it in like maybe 2 days of fully grinding, depending on how many badges your guy got, you know what I'm saying? So basically, first step y'all want to do, man, the first step, make sure y'all on a team with, you know, pretty good big men, you know. Maybe the Bucks, you could run with Giannis, but I wouldn't recommend it because only one person who could really go up and get those lobs and all that and help you out. So I say the Lakers is the best team for this. So what I did, man, I just called for screens every single time. I threw lobs to AD, you know, or LeBron, and I ain't gonna lie, yo, I got three playmaking badges in one game. You see, I've been going through this whole thing, this whole game, and got 40 assists, maybe 50. The highest I ever got was 60, you know what I'm saying? But to get at least two, you're gonna need at least 50 assists. Now, what I recommend y'all to do, just in case y'all new to the game, you know, there's four different categories: finishing, shooting, playmaking, and defense. You know what I'm saying? Defensive, you're going to get badges as you go along. You know, the way I get my defensive badges, I don't play any defense. I let the computer shoot. And, you know, sometimes they're going to, they just came in and throw some stupid stuff right there, and I got the board. That's one rebound towards my defensive badge. You keep doing that while you're grinding the rest of your badges, everything will follow suit. But you can only do one thing on offense: either finish at the rack, shoot the ball, or dime somebody. So basically, what you guys want to get out the way first is finishing and shooting. That's how y'all want to do it. Y'all want to get finishing and shooting out the way first. That's probably the most important thing, you know what I'm saying? Once you get finishing and shooting out, then it's the easy part, because all you have to do is call for screens like I'm doing with AD, throwing the lob up, boom. That's a bad example right there, but still, it works 90% of the time. I just happen to be going against the Clippers in this game, and you know the Clippers are not a bad defensive team, so they're not gonna allow you to get lobs every time. But if you go with smart lobs, you should be fine. Any other team, it works on 100%. Every single time, you will get that lob animation. Boom. You know what I'm saying? So it's best to be on, you know, go against weak defensive teams or small teams like the Rockets. You know what I'm saying? LeBron, go get every single time. And when you're grinding your finishing badges, guys, you want to do the same thing. You want to call for a screen, roll. Everybody gets a 90 plus dunk. So I don't see why you couldn't, why you're not going to be able to dunk every single time. Call for a screen with LeBron or AD, you know, roll off of it, get to the basket, finish just like that. Every single time, you know. Dunks count as the most, you get the most points for dunking. You get the most badge points for dunking the ball. So I suggest doing that a bunch of times. Maybe go for some layups. Maybe go for some post hooks, whatever. Everything that you can upgrade in that category when you're making your player, you can get badge points for doing in-game. So let's say shooting badges. Let's say I get like, I shoot 12 free throws that game. That goes towards your, you know, your badge progress for your shooting. Everything. Post fadeaways, mid-range threes, everything. And there's a cap too. 2K is just not going to let you shoot 155 threes and then it's going to still count. No. Like, I think in 2K18, they capped it off at like 30 threes or something like that. Then you wouldn't get any more extra points for it. And that, I don't know. That's just to prevent exploiting the game, the system. But honestly, you know, who cares? So I honestly shoot around 40 threes in this game. And then the rest is mid-ranges. You feel what I'm saying? You get more points that way. You feel what I'm saying? Maybe 50, 40, 45 threes. That should be good. So basically, there's an easy way to shoot threes. This shooting is the easiest thing you can do in the game. Easiest thing. So for shooting, guys, all you want to do, you know, I get the ball right there. Call for a quick isolation. You want to go slightly inside of the three-point line, do a step back, and shoot the ball. Boom. You're going to be open every single time. You see what I'm saying? It's pretty easy. Play it on pro, not Hall of Fame, to get your badges. Once you finish getting your badges, and you just want to get your guy to a 95 overall so you can start with that 99 process, yes, that's when you put it on Hall of Fame. But for now, just rocking on pro. You see I'm coming up the court, going inside the three-point line, step back, green, every single time. And especially if you have that high shot badge, Hall of Fame, you can get your takeover three times as fast. So, you know, it's going to be even better shooting. As long as you got that takeover, you're going to be automatic. I'm doing it again. Isolation, inside the three-point line, it don't matter who's guarding you, step back, green. And that's all you do for your shooting badges, even when you're in the mid-range. And you know, when you have your takeover, you can shoot in people's faces, you know, more often. So obviously, if you're trying to get your high spots, whatever, or shoot some mid-ranges, all you gotta do is get in that spot, maybe do like a quick little move, 1-2, and then shoot. I honestly only shoot mid-ranges when I have my takeover, because it becomes way too cluttered. Everybody's like in your vicinity in the mid-range, but you get way more space at the three-point line. So that's why I just shoot threes until I get my takeover, so I can shoot in people's faces. And that makes mid-ranges seem a little bit more easy. You feel what I'm saying? Step back, green, three. Bang. You know what I'm saying? Now I got team takeover for like four shots. But I'm not going to dive into that, you know what I'm saying? I just want to let y'all know how to get this Mamba Mentality badge as fast as possible. And listen, once you're done grinding your finishing, you know, you did your finishing, you're calling for screens, you know, you're dunking the ball, you're throwing lobs to each other, you know what I'm saying? I only suggest getting quick first step first. Quick first step got to be your first playmaking badge, because what if you want to hit the park? Your friends hit you up, well, I want to hit the park, let's go. You want to make sure you have that quick first step, the most important badge, you know, so you're not slow as rocks. So honestly, yeah, I have my takeover now. So now I'm like, in this video, I'm done with all my badges. So I'm just doing everything. I'm doing all my badges. I got every single badge upgrade. It's whatever now. So I taught you how to do the finishing, the shooting, the playmaking, the defense, all easy way. The easiest methods on how to do all that. you do this, you grind your finishing and shooting, and then you just focus on your defensive and your playmaking. And by the time you're done with your finishing and shooting, you should at least have at least half of your defensive badges done. You don't really focus on your defensive badges until the end, because you're going to get your defensive badges along the way. You know, you're going to get your defensive badges along the way of getting shooting, finishing, and playmaking. So you really don't have to worry about that until the very end. And then you will get Mamba Mentality badge in about 1-2 days max if you're really grinding. So basically, that's, you know, that's all I have to say. Make sure y'all get to grinding, y'all, because you're going to need that badge to have, just to have more fun in the game, you know, just to expand your knowledge of the game. You're going to need it, you know what I'm saying? So this is the easiest method possible to get it. Make sure y'all leave a like if you have it already. If you have it already, I'm not sure why you're watching this video. You might just be, you know, messing with me. Feel me? But make sure you comment if you have any questions below. Subscribe if you're new. Until my next video, I'm going to see y'all. Yo, that's a turn. I ain't going to lie. It's bad. But peace, y'all.